Mr. Mercado?
Present.
Mr. Lechner?
Here.
Chief Earl?
Here.
Mr. Carlemere?
Here.
Mr. Cardis?
Here.
We are experiencing some issues with our live streaming, but we're going to continue our... That's on? Okay, never mind. Disregard that. Tonight is a special evening for our township. The Gloucester Township Scholarship Committee will provide scholarships to high school seniors that are graduating this year from Gloucester Township schools or throughout the area. I'll hand it over to Dr. Hollington. Dr. Hollington?
Okay, thank you, Mr. Mercado. My name is Dick Hollinshead. I'm the treasurer of the Gloucester Township Day Scholarship Committee. We are an organization that has been in operation for over 30 years, and we really do two things. We try to provide a number of different events throughout the year, which hopefully will bring the community together. Many of you are from all different parts of the community. You know, Gloucester Township is a huge geographical area. And so what we try to do is run events that will hopefully bring the community together. Our culminating event each year is Gloucester Township Day, which is coming up June 4th, right next door in the park, and we hope to see a lot of you there. As we run these different events during the year, we make money. And so we take every penny that we make, we turn it back into scholarships for students who are graduating from high school this year. Any student who meets some certain criteria, whether they go to public, private, or parochial schools, are eligible as long as they reside in Gloucester Township. Before I give you a little bit more background information, I just want to acknowledge the other members of the committee who are here tonight. I'd like to ask them just to stand and hold your applause, please. I'd like to just give everybody an opportunity to be recognized. Our chairperson is Harry Morgan. The honorary chairperson is our mayor, Dave Mayer. Judy Weiserth is our secretary. The members of the committee are Tina Britta, Judy Calabrese, Debbie Carr, Mackenzie Carr, Chris Dizek, Chief Harry Earl, Judy Gore, Joan Eller Hinsky, Bill Fagan, Loretta Landy, Sandy Love, Lorena Melcher, Orlando Mercado, Patricia Price, Jasmine Robinson, Christina Rohrer, Anita Rowland, Michelle Traeger, Louise Tychak, and Debbie Wolf. This is the scholarship committee. As I mentioned, throughout the year, we raise money, and when it comes time to get ready to award the scholarships, we ask the students to apply, and there are basically four criteria that make a student eligible. First of all, they have to be a resident now and for at least the last 3 years in Gloucester Township. They must eventually be accepted to an accredited college or university, 2 or 4 year. They must score a combined 1200 on the SATs or a 17 on the ACT. And the final criterion is that they must be either in the top half of their graduating class or have accumulated a 2.5 GPA as of January of this year. As long as the students meet those criteria, we put them all in a pool. Now, we're going to be giving out 45 scholarships tonight. Each scholarship will be for $1,000. And in addition to picking those 45 students, we will also select 10 additional students whom we call alternates. Not everyone whose ping pong ball comes up today, and that's what you see over here. The 448 students who qualify each have a ping pong ball in there. Each of you has a piece of paper, I hope, with 448 names and numbers. If anybody does not have this, could you put your hand up and we'll get one to you? Lorena, there's one back there and one over here. Just keep your hand up and we have somebody distributing that to you. This is your cheat sheet for tonight. You need this. Most of you have already found the most important number on there, and hopefully you're doing whatever you need to do to make that happen. But we will select the 45 ping pong balls. Those people will be awarded a $1,000 scholarship, provided that they go to college. If it turns out that they do not go to college and are not enrolled by September of 2016, then we go to the first alternate, and so on down through 10 alternates. We've never had to go to 10, but there have been years when we've had to do 4 or 5 of them because of extenuating circumstances. If you are an alternate, but you don't get a scholarship, we're still gonna send you $100. So basically, there will be 55 people who will get some money tonight. I shouldn't say it that way. We aren't giving out actual money tonight because obviously we're not in a position to do that. We have to check to make sure that the students have met the criteria and particularly that they're going to college. So you're going to need this as we go through the evening. I did mention there are 448 names on there, and what we've done is we've put them in alphabetical order. And I have to say this, one year we had a mistake in the spelling of a student's name. I shouldn't say we, it was my fault because I was doing the typing. What it did was it switched the position numerically, alphabetically for a student because I thought it was an A and somebody, the student's name really was an E. The wrong student got selected, but there's nothing we can do about that. What I want to say to you is that what's on here, as it says at the top, each eligible student has been assigned a number by the committee. The number shown on this list will be official, even if the student's name has been misspelled. So if we did misspell your name, we apologize, but there was no way with this number that we could possibly go back and check everything. So hopefully everything is correct, and we'll certainly be able to tell which student is which based on this. So tonight what we're going to do is draw these numbers. I should tell you that we've been doing this for 31 years. The very first year, in 1986, we awarded 8 scholarships in the amount of $500 each. We've been able to make more and more money each year, although these days it's getting harder to raise funds. But we've been able, over the course of 31 years, so that this year, we will have given out, at the end of the cycle, a total of 1,240 scholarships in the total amount of $1,085,200. And none of this is possible without the work of the people on the committee who organize different events, but really also all of you, because hopefully you come to some of our events. If you haven't in the past, we've got a couple of big ones coming up. If you get lucky tonight, you might feel you're on a roll. We've got a coach bingo coming up April 29th. I think we passed out flyers on that. So this can be a wonderful opportunity for you to go even further. And Chris Dizek, who is sitting in the second row here, she just put her hand up. At the end of the evening, she'll be in the back. And she has tickets, but it also says on the page how you can contact her through email and get tickets. That'll be April 29th at the Glendora Fire Hall. It's one of a number of the events that we run during the year. We recently had a 5K run, actually this past Saturday. It was a little bit strange with snow coming down when people were running, but the real runners say it doesn't matter as long as it's not windy. We had a good turnout. That was another one of our fundraisers. And another one we had recently that you may want to think about for the future when we advertise, we had a real successful wine tasting. Sponsored by Sharrett's Winery. So as you can see by the kinds of things I've mentioned, we try to do a lot of different things to draw as many different people in, always with the purpose of collecting money and turning it back to the kids. So this year again, 45 scholarships in the amount of $1,000 each. I should also say, some of you may have noticed that one of the names I read off here as member of the committee is Mr. Mercado, who is the president of council. Not only has he been very supportive, he actually organized our race over the weekend, but it's also true that our mayor, Dave Mayer, who's right here, who's our honorary chairperson, has been extremely supportive in terms of helping the committee and realizing that we can help the community and the township can help us to try to make some of these events work as smoothly as possible. Every mayor, starting with Ann Mullen back in the 80s, has been very supportive, as has been the entire council. So it's been a real cooperative effort and one that we're very proud to be a part of. I think that those are the main things that I wanted to say, and now it's simply a matter of drawing some ping pong balls. So whatever you need to do to conjure up your number, please do that. And I guess the other thing I wanted to mention to you is that we are not in school. There are no decorum rules here. If you win, it's okay to cheer. You can do whatever you would like within reason and, you know, propriety and all that kind of stuff. But this is a fun evening. For us, this is really the culmination, even though we have a couple of more events. This is what we're all about. And so we want to have a good time, and we want you to have a good time. And hopefully being here and doing whatever you can do will help you to have your number come up. So, Mr. Mayor, are you ready to help us here? Number 263, that is Kyrie Michaelchuk from Highland. By the way, I apologize for how small these fonts are. I'm hoping that you can do it. Okay, number six. Number six. All right, we have a winner here from Timber Creek. That's Bailey Almond. Almond? Okay, very, very good. Congratulations. Number 402. That is Michael Taylor from Highland. The Highland kids, most of them are not here because they're on their senior trip. So there are a lot of Highland students not present. Number 247 is from Highland again, Jacob Matzinger. Number 236 is from Timber Creek, James Lyon. It's okay to cheer even if it's not you. That's okay. That's great. 232 from Triton, Carly Lilia. Hopefully I'm not messing up these names. Number 319.
Yes!
All right. Okay, number 319 is Mariah Polk from Timber Creek. Congratulations. That seems to be a good section right there if anybody wants to move around. Number 153. Back on the front side of the paper, 153 from Timber Creek, Matthew Grouse. Number 20, Alexis Baldwin Heller from Timber Creek. Number 224, another winner. Okay, 224 is Kelly Lemon. Thank you. Okay. We're passing the baton here, or whatever it is. Mix them up, all right. I told you you were gonna have to watch him. 238. 238 is Tyreek Maddox-Williams from Timber Creek. Number 305. Is Julianne Oswald from Timber Creek. Okay, very good. Number 185 is Taryn Irving from Timber Creek. Number 173 is Kevin Herman from Triton. Number 71 is Daniel Kraft from Highland.
You got two of your sleeves.
429 is Casey Wagner from Timber Creek. Number 157 is Kirsten Gunningbell from Highland. I can't see. Number 178 is Juwan Hooks from Highland. Okay. We need somebody who doesn't have a coat on. All right. Did you scrub? Okay, you scrubbed. Number 445, that's Caitlin Zawatsky from Highland. Yay.
Hey, you're on number, that was 19, we're at 181
is Aaron Howard from Timber Creek. Number 25 is Annabelco from Triton. Number 161 is Jillian Hall from Highland. Celine Foxworth from Timber Creek. Number 95, Ann DiGiulielmo from Highland. Oh. I know I didn't pronounce that one right. Number 234 is Nicholas Lombardo from Highland. Wow. Number 431, Christopher Walton from Highland. Number 208 is Emily Kinsler from Timber Creek. Number 349 is Natalie Rush from Timber Creek. Someone else like to come down? Number 5, Sophia Alger from Timber Creek. Number 77, congratulations, number 77 is Gabrielle Daisy from Triton. Number 364 is Anthony Scalise from Triton. Number 281 is Brian Murphy from Highland. Is that you? All right, congratulations. Number 62 is Brandon Clegg from Triton. Number 134 is Brittany Garrison from Highland. Number 246 is Gabriel Martirano from Highland.
Gabriel?
Gabriel. Number 384 is Victoria Speakman from Timber Creek. I don't know about you, but my paper, the font is getting smaller as the evening is going on. Number 31 is Jacqueline Bonner from Timber Creek. Number 391 is Courtney Straub from Paul the Sixth. Mr. Hutchison, thank you.
96.
Number 96. All right, 96 is Brendan Gilmore from Triton. Congratulations.
Three zero one
is Kemi Olajuwa from Timber Creek. Thank you. Thank you very much.
373.
Number 373 is Sarah Shahid from Highland. Number 282 is Tariq Mustafa from Highland.
356.
Number 356 is Taylor Santiago from Highland.
Two more.
302. Kristen Olson from Highland. Number 430 is Jeremy Wallace from Timber Creek. Thank you, Mr. Hutchison. Okay, those were the 45 $1,000 scholarships. We're now going to be doing the 10 alternates, and the order here is important, so we'll be recording that because alternate number one would be the first replacement, person. Number 193 is the first alternate, and 193 is Nadia Junkaj from Timber Creek. I have to bring you up here to help me with these. Number 86. 86 is Ryan Davis from Highland. 400 is Mario Tassi III from Timber Creek. Number 9 is the next one. Christian Anderson from Highland. Number 381 is Varen Soni from Timber Creek. Next one is 164. 164 is Joshua Hanneman from Highland. Next is 357. That's John Santini from Paul the Sixth. Next is number 21, Kaijane Banks from Highland. We got two more. Number 251 is Javon McDaniel from Timber Creek, and the last number is 264. 264 is Anthony Scalise. 264 or 364? I'm sorry, I read the same name twice. 264. I waited till the last one to screw up. Kayla Michelle from Timber Creek. Okay. I'm sorry that not everyone could win. Obviously, the chances were about 1 in 10 tonight. We had 448 names, and we picked 45 scholarships, so that's around 1 in 10. If you throw in the alternates, your odds got a little bit better. But our idea here is to involve as many people as possible, and we're very, very pleased that you came out tonight and that you had an opportunity to see how the committee works and what we're all about. Hopefully, we'll see some of you playing Coach Bingo on April 29th and maybe coming up to the festivities right here on Gloucester Township Day on Saturday, June 4th. At this point, I'd like to... Will you be taking a recess briefly? Okay. The council will be taking a brief recess. We would like to get all the winners and alternates to wait for us in the back here. We'd like to get a picture of all of you who are winners. And if the student is not here, it's okay for mom to be there instead. And we just like to commemorate this as best we can. So again, thank you very much. Appreciate your support and have a good evening.
I said, go to the cop over there. See if he has a blood pressure thing or if he wants to check my heart rate, whatever. By the time she got out the door, he pulled out with the other one. So she comes back in, and somebody else came in and said, let me take your present. And at that point, it was up to like one side.
So they finally got there. It was virtual EMTs, and they could show something. They said, hold back my elbow. And he said, Debbie, I need to do something right away. Can you hear me? He said, put your head down between your legs. I put my head down between my legs. He said, push like you're giving her. I tried that. Nothing. He says, all right, get her back. He says, she's up to 222. We've got to give it to her now. And I don't know what the hell you're talking about. I said, what do you give me? I said, please don't tell me I need a pacemaker, because today my dad said nobody wished him a happy anniversary. It's 10 years today that he got his pacemaker. And I'm a nervous wreck. What was it called? Adenosine. They gave me something, shot me up, and he said, you're going to feel a kick in your chest. I didn't feel a kick, but I felt something very, like calming. Like, it just slows it down. And I was like,
can slow it down to nothing.
Well, he said, you were basically nothing, and then it picks back up, and it was like 1:30.
It only lasted like 20 seconds.
It was so good.
But it's enough to break that.
I mean, he said, on the way on the ambulance, because I was just going to take me to the wards. Actually, I was like, can I go to virtual so we're helping our doctors or our park doctor? He said that was a bunch of choices. The choices are Cooper or
Rosemary. Who did he say?
Have ladies.
Oh, okay.
So they don't want me to go to Levi. They want me to go to Levi.
He's the EP guy.
Now that's what they told me. And my dad and my husband both said, get it, Pat. I said, I don't want to go to Pat Ladies.
Pat Ladies will make you see the other one.
That's what I figured. I can't see. I can't see him for like weeks, but I can see Pat Ladies Thursday. And he's like, you haven't been to a doctor, a cardiologist. I said, yeah.
How about, did they offer you Dr. Markov?
Yeah, they just said Dr. Levy, and I said, well, can I go to Pat Ladies? And she said, I have a cancellation for him this Thursday, 3:45, so I'm going back in. But Wednesday will be a week, and the only thing they did was Friday, they gave me an echo, and I went to the heart house over because they had an open there. But they told me the reason they were sending me to a heart hospital was because they'll probably want to do a chest x-ray. An hour and a half.
Oh, that's awesome.
And they were like, the ER guy said, we're going to do this,
Saturday
this,
Friday.
Wednesday.
Oh, Wednesday. That's right.
It was like 1:30, 2 o'clock in the afternoon. It was about 2 o'clock when I
that's
got
awesome.
There, I think.
Usually
and I was home by dinner.
That's awesome.
But I was mad because he said the reason we're sending you there was so they could do an echo, a chest x-ray, and if they have to do anything. And now they're sending
me outpatient. But if all that stuff is normal and you're not in the rhythm, there's nothing they can do.
Well, that's what I wanted to ask you. So, like, somebody told me that it could be like the guy, he was really nice, the guy in the ambulance that went with me, he was just really, it was actually the medics, the paramedics, it was on the ambulance. He said it could be benign, it could be temporary, it could just be, but he said, I think you have SVT. And I'm like, okay. So I said, can I text? He's like, you're not driving the ambulance, go ahead. So I texted Donna. I'm like, Donna, I texted you like 30 minutes ago, what happened? And she said, sure, I was driving. This is Donna Donovan, she works for Dr. Tosano. She's the nurse there.
Oh, Donna, yeah.
You know Donna, she's my Avon lady too. So he said, who told you you had SVT? I said, my Avon lady. You should have seen her eyes.
Sure.
I said, but she also works in my doctor's office. I said, but she told me if it's as simple as SVT, you'll be okay. And I texted her back and said, that's what they said they think it is.
If it's an AFib, then both of them you can go in and out of. SVT is better.
Congratulations for your son.
Thank you very much.
So AFib is not the same as SVT.
Yeah, we're happy.
I didn't think so, because someone said, if you're an AFib, I'm like, that's not what they told me. I was calm.
My father lost that all the time.
They said it could be hereditary. They said it could be. I didn't even drink a lot of caffeine.
I have a girlfriend who started going to
AFib. Oh my God. Wait, Bill,
that was 2 years ago, maybe 3 years ago. You know, so she was like 45.
Right.
She had an ablation.
I said, Dad.
Okay. hasn't gone back into it, so.
Wow. Well, they put me on Centopril, and they said stay on that till you see a dialysis and see what he wants to do, because I am on Enalapril.
What time are you seeing?
That's what I figured.
3:45 on Thursday.
That's what you have to do? Yeah.
Because I really would like to go with Levy, because that's what I'm supposed to, but, and I didn't want to waste an appointment.
Because what you hate is to happen is you see probably then you gotta go.
Then I have to go back.
I know.
But they would,
so let me, I'll talk to the office.
Okay.
And see if they.
I don't want Steph to go.
Or if he's in the office, they would check in.
Maybe check in.
Okay. I know he's not in the hospital.
That's the only problem with the one bed.
And I can't remember if it's days.
He's got a
day. Morning or the afternoon.
Worst case, we're going to
find out tomorrow.
Okay.
I'll ask Mark.
All right, then just call me. I'll be in work tomorrow. You have my number.
Okay.
But just, okay. I was looking for you because that's my office.
And Michelle's in.
Room number 6. I don't know where anybody is.
I was there Wednesday.
Were you really?
You had my number. You should have called me.
Well, yeah.
No, you know what? It's her phone. Take her
phone. She answers 24/7. All right. Thank you. I appreciate it.
What's up, Pam?
What can you tell us?
It's a great day. Well, I'm very quiet.
Yeah.
Tomorrow, what I want to do.
He's on a video.
Press down a little bit.
Yeah, I saw the fucking half.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Okay.
Your backyard?
Hello, stranger. Good, how are you?
Okay.
My I know. He said my dad and my mom has Alzheimer's. Between my sister and mother and I, we are very, hands on. You watch it wear him down. It's scary. It's scary.
We're taking turns staying overnight.
I know, we were doing his college thing. It just dawned on me.
If you could just let him know that Ken, I'll knock on the door first. All right, I'm trying to think.
My daughter's not home if
he's
home, it's between school and work.
Madam Clerk, may I have the roll call, please?
Mrs. Winters?
Here.
Mrs. Yen?
Here.
Mrs. Estrada?
Here.
Mr. Mercado?
Present. Now we'll have the first public portion. Anyone wish to speak, please raise your hand. Paul Dorham?
Good evening, Councilor Ray Polidori.
Good evening.
Ariel. Could I get a little bit of a clarification on, I think it's agenda item 118, having to do with litigation, opening up in litigation in the Ariel ambulance property, and what that in plain language means, please.
Okay. Back in 1981, the Township of Gloucester deeded the property that the Ariel ambulance squad resided into for $1. And in the deed, it would revert back to the township if they weren't a fully functioning organization. So in 2012, they ceased their operations. And so this is a resolution to reclaim that parcel, that particular building. Mr. Carmen, anything you want to add to that?
That's correct. Volunteer organization.
that at some one point in time was either declared inactive and revoked by the state.
I'm sorry, is your microphone working?
A couple of times the organization was determined inactive and their charter revoked for failure to file and maintain their volunteer status.
What time was that?
That was a couple times.
It was March 31st, 1987, reinstated in July 7th of 2011, inactive again and revoked on August 16th, 2013, and then recently was reinstated March 30th, 2016, and I believe it was reinstated because they heard that this motion or this resolution was on the agenda.
The building's been closed for some time. There's no ambulance, all the medical supplies and files have been taken out of the building.
Gloucester Township EMS is operating out of the old Lindor Rescue Squad on Taylor Avenue, off Choose Landing Road.
When was the last time that the aerial ambulance squad was functioning? What was the last date about?
2012.
Yeah, 2012 in that period of time. But they were operating at some point in time, subsidizing or assisting the Gloucester Township EMS Alliance organization, not the current one, the prior one, as a volunteer. The EMS Alliance was a corporation, not-for-profit corporation, that had a board of directors and career EMTs.
Okay. My question, I guess, would be, with that being the case, why now, after the 2012 inaction of that? Why at this particular time?
Just ready. There was a lot of talk over the last couple of years. Between the GTEMS alliance that's operating today, just surfaced and time to do.
Okay. Now, with that would be the property and the building. Is that correct?
That's correct.
Okay. Now, the property and the building within that building used to house the emergency equipment, ambulance number 887. That has since then been removed from the property. My understanding is the individual that removed that also removed whatever documents and records were in that building, which, to my understanding, is could be construed as patient information, should be in the strictest of confidence now before Gloucester Township goes ahead to procure this property again. What will the township do to ensure that the personal information of individuals in our town is secure and safe, and where the whereabouts are for that if access is not accessible for anyone but the person that is in possession of the vehicle and the documents?
I don't have direct knowledge of the vehicle and the documents. I mean, I've heard stories as to where it is, but it's not in the building. And this action is just to recover the land and building that's there. The ambulance is not there, hasn't been there for a long time. And what I've heard is that the medical records that they maintain have been out of the building for some time.
Okay, with hearing that, not knowing that for sure, and you're going to move forward with this evening, is that also not, if you do procure that building, is not Gloucester Township possibly going to be held liable for whatever confidential information has left that building or is in that building, or the knowledge of where it's at this particular time before you proceed?
If the township is successful and acquires the building back and has access to it, and there are records in there, the township will act accordingly.
Okay. My other quick question, and I know we took up some time on that. I see that we're buying a lot more vehicles with plows. My first question is, when the bids go out for this, where will the funds come for all these vehicles?
They're in our capital budget, correct, Mr. Carter? Mr. Carter, that's correct.
Okay. And as of today, what other municipalities, towns, boroughs, or halls are we providing plowing service for outside of Gloucester Township?
We don't provide any.
Any salting, anything to do with weather-related?
We have shared services for them to purchase brine from us, but that's not us doing the services. They have their equipment to lay the brine down.
Okay.
And we bill them with a administrative fee also.
Thank you.
Thank you. Anyone else?
Excuse me, sir.
Ms. Sarah, is it an agenda item or just the general?
One concern was about the yard beef machine.
Okay, you can.
Want to get
Craig,
it?
Yes.
I'll make it very brief.
Are you going to? I can hold him. Okay. Good evening, Council. Sarah B. Young is my name. I see you've made some changes since I was here late. I see some new faces up there. And congratulations, new president. And to all of you, I'm very happy to see you. And congratulations for all the wonderful things that you do for this township. Some of you remember, this hurts my heart to bring this up, Councilman that sat in that chair, I certainly would like to sit there sometime before I leave this earth, that chair right there, one of those chairs. His name is Colonel Sala, Samuel Sala. You have a veterans park over there. And his name, I almost need a magnifying glass to find it, but it's up front there, Samuel Sala. He is very ill. And for some reason, it's a family affair, and they don't want, at one time until I broke the winning name, he's been asking for me for a long time. And my name is up front, do not let her in. Now, I'm a Christian lady, and I do what I think is right, and I need your prayers. And I did what I had to do, and I did get in, thanks to one of the policemen, and I wrote him a note and tried to commend him, and I'm sure by now you've heard who it was. I need you to pray for Samuel Sala. He is not well at all. He has missed seeing people for a long time. He managed to somehow get my name out, get Sarah Young here, somehow, I don't know. And when I went, they said, are you Sarah Young? They said, you're not coming in here. And I started to say, you and who else gonna stop me? But I didn't. I'm asking you to pray for Sam Sala. He is having a serious problem. And it's, I can't tell you everything I want to, but just go see for yourself. And you can get in. And if any of you know him, see what you can do to help him. I can't do it all by myself. God is on the throne. Now the last thing I mention is the street, the leaf here, the 14-yard leaf machine. I live on Peter Cheeseman. I'm so disturbed I can't even think of my own address, but whatever it is, 2306. And we would like to see some trucks coming through, at least sweeping the street. They used to come through now and then, but now sometimes I don't see them at all. But when I go down to that hall where they're supposed to be and they're all out there waiting to get off at 5 o'clock, playing and having fun and don't have time. And I said, well, could I talk to whoever's in charge? Oh, there's no one here in charge. And I'm just not happy with the things that I'm seeing in some places around here. But I do want to commend you and thank you for hearing me. Bye.
Thank you, Ms. Sarah. Appreciate it. Anyone else? Seeing none, we'll close the first public portion. Proclamation.
Whereas alcohol is a primary factor for the 4 leading causes of death for young persons ages 10 to 21, and whereas alcohol is the most commonly used addictive substance in the United States, and whereas young people who begin drinking before age 15 are 4 times more likely to develop alcohol dependence than those who begin drinking at age 21, and whereas the typical American will see 100,000 beer commercials before he or she turns 18, and whereas kids who drink are more likely to be victims of violent crime, to be involved in alcohol-related traffic crashes, and to have serious school-related problems, and whereas a supportive family environment is associated with lowered rates of alcohol use for adolescents, and whereas consistent and sustained parental attitudes can influence a child's decision about whether or not to use alcohol and drugs, and whereas kids who have conversations with their parents learn a lot about the dangers of alcohol and drug use are 50% less likely to use alcohol and drugs than those who don't have such conversations. Therefore, I, David Mayer, Mayor, and I, Orlando Mercado, President of Council, now join the National Council on Alcoholism and Drug Dependence, and do hereby proclaim that April 2016 is Alcohol Awareness Month in the Township of Gloucester. We also call upon all citizens, parents, governmental agencies, public and private institutions, businesses, hospitals, schools, and colleges in our community to support efforts that will provide early education about alcoholism, addiction, and increased support for individuals and families coping with alcoholism. Through these efforts together, we can provide hope, health, and healing for those in our community who are facing challenges with alcohol use and abuse.
Thank you, Madam Clerk. Bids?
Two small dump trucks with plow, 2016 pickup with plow, utility body truck with plow, 14-yard leaf machine, 20-yard rear load refuse truck.
I'll entertain a motion.
Second.
On the question, roll call, please.
Mr. Hutchison?
Yes.
Mr. Schmidt?
Yes.
Mrs. Winters?
Yes.
Mr. Mignon?
Yes.
Mrs. Estrada?
Yes.
Mr. Mercado?
Yes. Next, we have our resolutions, our consent agenda. Any council person who would like to remove any of the items, please speak up. Hearing none, I entertain a motion to accept the consent agenda as presented.
So moved.
Second.
On the question, roll call, Madam Clerk.
Mr. Hutchison?
Yes.
Mr. Schmidt?
Yes.
Mrs. Winters?
Yes.
Mr. Mignon?
Yes.
Mrs. Estrada?
Yes.
Mr. Mercado?
Yes. We did not receive any GTE Gov Access emails. We'll have our second public portion. Anyone wishing to speak, please raise your hand. Mr. Polidoro.
Hey, Polidoro. Here we go. On resolution 160413 that you just approved on the consent agenda, did that go forward without the inclusion of the Field of Dreams?
Yes.
Why?
Because I said we were going to take a look into the Field of Dreams. This is a change, adding signage on the field. That discussion with Field of Dreams, I had a discussion with the mayor and also with our business administrator, looking at some different options and looking to restart it. I did get a dollar amount. Last week I attended the Rotary meeting, and Joe Castor, who is the treasurer of the Rotary, provided me a dollar amount of $137,000 that they are holding on to for the Field of Dreams. But no, it's not included in this change order.
With $137,000 to the good towards that field, and I have huge problem believing that that field could possibly cost the same to turf over as a soccer or football field, but that's another story. With $137,000, the difference would be, as this went from a privately funded program project to a, as the previous president had indicated, was going to be a publicly funded program. Even if you took the two of them together, this program could have been done. Could have been done this year. I asked you at the last meeting, and instead of being governmental, you deferred to the mayor, as if the mayor had the decision-making process to do your job. You deferred to the mayor, and you could have had a discussion on that, and you chose not to and gave it up to the mayor. I was expecting that maybe you would have commented on that before this tonight, because I asked this year for a reason, and I also believed that there was another reason. I didn't go down that path of what other reason that the Field of Dreams could great make a great pomp and circumstance in an election year next year. And if that field goes on this list and gets done during an election year next year, I will call you out on it, and I'll call you for the shameful act that you've done when you should have put that field this year for those children instead of how many fields at the community center, how many over here, how many over there. This was the year to do that. You had the money. You borrowed the money to do this, and you failed to put that field for physically and mentally disabled children. This year you had the money, and you've got a company coming in here that could have banged that out along with the funding from the Rotary. I don't get like this very often with you guys, but I think you would be ashamed of yourself. That was horrible. That was horrible. All that turf, that company's going to come into this town and make a mountain of money for their services, and we won't have a Field of Dreams done this year. When those children will see that as they're being walked around with their whatever they're using for assistance, whether it be a wheelchair or whatever, and they're going to see fields that have AstroTurf on the same part that their field has been sitting with absolutely nothing for 3 years. I don't get this mad about politics, but that you should be ashamed of yourself for. Find a way to get that Field of Dreams done this year. Don't let that pass. I'm going to tell you again that there's children that can utilize that field this year. And because of their disabilities, it may not go to next year. They may not be able to use that field. And some of you shook your head like you really, really felt that you agreed with something that I said. And what happened? 7-0 vote. You turn those kids away this year. Don't let it happen next year. Do it this year and get it done. Because you don't see me like this often. And this ain't about politics. Don't make it about politics. If there's anyone that would like to say something to me, I'd invite you to say it.
Ray.
Yes.
I'm going to ask you to join me in help jumpstarting this effort. Because in those 3 years that we first announced this, I've never seen you at any one of these activities. I don't believe you've dedicated one single dollar to these activities. You sit up here and you make comments. You tell us that you are ashamed of us. Well, I'm going to ask you to help me jumpstart.
Consider it done.
Okay.
Consider it done. Right. You do what you can to get it done for this year, and you'll have my time, you'll have my money, you'll have my effort. You can call me out anytime you want. I'm always going to do it, but you better make that happen this year if you want to play that. Let's get those kids playing on that field this year. Actually, it would be a great thing for that to be the very first field done for those children. Thank you.
Thank you. Have a great evening. Anyone else?
Yeah, the public will be behind me. They'll
Thanks.
Ask you what's going on. They say they don't know, they come to me, and you know.
Thanks. Ms. Carr.
Joanne Carr, Timber Birch. I wanted to say thank you for the action you've taken on the abandoned houses, and hope, I don't know how long these things take to take effect, but I have 3 abandoned houses on my block, so I'm really watching with interest to see what happens. My neighborhood, Timberline White Birch, Timber Birch, since before Christmas, the PSE&G has been roaming all around, and then all of a sudden you see little flags on your lawn. Oh, you have a gas leak. Oh, you have a gas leak. And he said, well, what do you got? Well, you don't want your house to blow up. So 3 houses on my block, they came and they drilled the street. And then they came and they dug up my curb strip and they replaced things. And then my next door neighbor and then the lady 4 houses down. And you drive through and you see them. I mean, like, they're making a profession of it. It's all through Timber Birch. Now, our neighborhood is of an age. It was built in 1956. So they're 60-year-old houses, some of the older ones, and some of the pipes and things need to be addressed. I haven't seen them in the last week, but this week the water company decided to come. And the Eaton Place entrance, which is the furthest most eastern entrance, great big backhoes and everything, and they've got a big long strip coming down all of Eaton Place, and then it's going up Tilford, now it's going around Clement, and at the front of the entrance there's a big sign, your New Jersey Water Company dollars at work. Are my New Jersey Water Company dollars going to pave that street now that we've got all of this torn up street? Have you heard anything, John? Do we know anything? Or are they just going to come and rip our streets up?
Well, we had passed a resolution, an ordinance a couple years ago, particularly when CCNUA was putting in new lines up and down the road throughout the township, Choosing Lane Road, that no longer just to pass that particular area, but also go from the middle of the road to the curb. Is that something, Mr. Canada?
Yeah, that would apply here.
Can enforce?
Eaton Place itself, the entrance road itself, which is in bad shape, that's part of the 2016 road program.
Okay.
It probably won't go out until the bid until the fall. but
Clement has been.
We might have to do some accommodation with that there, but where they're putting pipelines and entrenching the road, but we aren't doing any paving, they are obligated to come back and repave that trench at least one half. They don't do the entire road, but at least on part of the road.
So that would be the water company.
That would be the water company's job.
The gas company has been, my one neighbor has like 14 holes drilled in front of her house. And it's all patched and everything.
Mm-hmm.
Is anything going to be addressed with the gas company? I mean, like, I know we can't get the whole thing repaved. And I've been blessed because our block has been replaced more frequently than other blocks in our development. No wonder why. I don't know why, but... Yeah, I know. It must be me. It must be me. Except for the fact that now we've got all of this, you know, repair work that's going to need to be addressed. Take a ride by. Just see what's going on and call the water company. Call the gas company and say...
What street has a little holes in?
Clement Drive. Number 14 has 14 holes in front of it. Oh yeah, and they came and they replaced her water meter and everything. With mine, they, you know, you come home and you find flags going right down the side of the lawn and around your backyard and you wonder what's going on. Fortunately enough for me, the leak was at the curb strip. They dug my curb strip up. So they really only drilled 3 holes in front of my house. But they no sooner got done mine and they said, oh, your next door neighbor needs it too. They had to dig my, what they just dug up, to get to hers. They could have done it all on the same day, but that's another story. But I noticed them in different parts of the development. They're riding through, and I guess, as I said, with age, these things need to be replaced, but shouldn't there be some kind of coordination with the town as to damage to the street? I mean, call before you dig. Every one of them was out there. There were yellow flags for the gas company, and there were blue flags for the water company. And then I came by, and there's one guy sitting in his car, and I said, what's this about? And he said, oh, you have a gas leak or something. He says, I'm with the electric and all that. I said, we don't have any underground electric in Timber Birch. We're all wires overhead. Because yeah, I know, I just have to come out here. And he sat and ate his lunch and, you know, hid. So, all right, I just wanted to put it out there so that you're aware of what's happening on our streets.
Mr. Cars, can you follow with Public Works to see if they're aware of this, so the Clement Drive?
The water company did mine. They replaced the line, I guess it was like 2 years ago. They did repave the half once they were all done.
Okay.
There was a patch in the beginning, and then they did come out and do the half. It was about 2 years.
It's a great big long strip. It was like a trench that they did, and it's wrapping around.
5 or 6 houses or so, maybe, that they did. But they did repave the half.
Thank you. Thank you for that. Okay.
It took a little while, but they did.
Well, what got me was the sign. These are our water dollar works. Money's at work. My money works a lot of different places. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Is there anyone else? Seeing none, close the second public portion. Calling the directors.
Mr. Lechner?
I have nothing to report, thank you.
Chief Earl?
Nothing to report, thank you.
Mr. Carlemere?
Nothing to report.
Cantwell?
Nothing to report.
Mr. Cardis?
Nothing to report.
Mr. Hutchison?
Congratulations to the scholarship winners. Have a good night.
Mr. Schmidt?
Also, congratulations to the scholarship winners and thank you very much to the scholarship committee. Also, well done again, Orlando, on the race. It was snowing, and it was really something, and you did a very fine job. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Mrs. Winters?
I want to congratulate all the winners, and, you know, it's so nice seeing all these different names, you know, almost 450 names that were eligible, so that's nice to see. Have a great week.
Mr. Mignon?
Congratulations to the winners. So not only did they have some brains, but tonight they had a little bit of luck as their ping pong ball was picked. Thank you.
Congratulations to the scholarship winners, and congratulations, Orlando, on another successful 5K
run, and I'll always be out there, rain or shine, giving out water. But congratulations.
Mr. Mercado.
I want to thank everyone for coming out this evening. I want to thank the police, Public Works, EMS, the Rec Department for helping out with the Gloucester Township Scholarship 5K. We netted a little bit over $10,000 for the race. That's 10 scholarships. We had 144 people out there despite the snow. Bigger and better next year. Thank the Historical Society. I saw some pictures for the open house yesterday. I couldn't make it. I had ran a race. I was a little tired afterwards. And also St. Baldrick's, which was an event held at the Palace. Debbie Simone is on the school board, runs that fundraising effort, and I believe is, I think, close to $50,000 that they raised yesterday in cancer research. So, with that, I'll entertain. Oh, thank you. Have a great evening. With that, I entertain a motion to adjourn. Is there a second? All in favor? Thank you. Have a good evening.
Second.